Music reduces depression. According to a study, more than 350 million people suffer from depression around the world. A whopping 90% of them also experience insomnia. The sleep research above found that symptoms of depression decreased significantly in the group that listened to particular music, or by music intervention process, MIP, before bedtime. This process of listening to music, along with the practice of keeping a bedtime routine, will prepare his body to adjust itself and relax the muscles, which is also a process of the body falling asleep. Another study by Hans-Joachim Trapp in Germany also demonstrated that music can benefit patients with depressive symptoms, depending on the type of music. Meditative sounds and classical music lifted people up their moods and elevated their spirits. According to the Harvard Medical School, research suggests that depression doesn't spring from simply having too much or too little of certain brain chemicals. Rather, there are many possible causes of depression, including faulty mood regulation by the brain, genetic vulnerability, stressful life events, medications, and medical problems. It's believed that several of these forces interact to bring on depression. The study on the brain's impact on depression showed that certain areas of the brain help regulate mood. Researchers believe that, more important than levels of specific brain chemicals, nerve cell connections, nerve cell growth, and the functioning of nerve circuits have a major impact on depression. Still, their understanding of the neurological underpinnings of mood is incomplete. Research shows that the hippocampus is smaller in some depressed people. For example, in one fMRI study published in the Journal of Neuroscience, investigators studied 24 women who had a history of depression. On average, the hippocampus was 9% to 13% smaller in depressed women, compared with those who were not depressed. The more bouts of depression a woman had, the smaller the hippocampus. Stress, which plays a role in depression, may be a key factor here, since experts believe stress can suppress the production of new neurons, nerve cells, in the hippocampus. The answer may be that mood only improves as nerves grow and form new connections, a process that takes weeks, and this process can be assisted with music, because music has a direct effect on one's moods and emotions. The ultimate goal in treating the biology of depression is to improve the brain's ability to regulate mood. We now know that neurotransmitters are not the only important part of the machinery, but let's not diminish their importance either. They are deeply involved in how nerve cells communicate with one another, and they are a component of brain function that we can often influence by music intervention process, MIP, to good ends. The famous American poet Maya Angelou once said, "Music was my refuge. I could crawl into the space between the notes and curl my back to loneliness." Many great people all around the world understood this magical response of the human body due to listening to calm, relaxing musical harmonies. The next time you feel low, put on some classical or meditative music to lift your spirits. Relax. Enjoy listening to music.